On this planet, someone like it, someone reject it, but almost everyone can't live without it. It is all around you. Hey, wait a minute, it is right on your body. What is it? Made in China. Made in China has made its mark in every corner of the globe. From the poorest village in Africa to the richest city in America. In Africa, the slippers on the villagers' feet are all made in China. In America, finding out a Sheriff Woody or Buzz Lightyear that is not made in China is also a mission impossible.
China is Chinese. It's going to be the seven part to where everything comes from. Everything came from China. China, you look on the tag, even when I was a kid, China. Everything that I got came from China.
The newly concluded London Games provided a vivid account of how the world is attached to made in China. The fireworks, artificial grass, computers, souvenirs, mascots, even the uniforms for members of the US Olympic team are made in China. If there were no made in China, there would be no London Olympics. As the London Games showed, made in China makes life easy for the world, and the world in turn provides a vast market for the former. It's hard to imagine how life would be without Chinese products. Concerning this, no one knows better than the American journalist Sarah, who wrote the famous book, A Year Without Made in China. Sarah and her family attempted to boycott any products made in China for a whole year. However, her adventure only ended up in a series of troubles. Cell phones, computers, televisions, clothes, toys, tools, lamps, sneakers, sunglasses. It's hard to find a living good without a made in China label. It's wiser to coexist with Chinese imports than to boycott them. This is Sarah's final conclusion, and perhaps a consensus of the majority. Elites run the world, but they are those ordinary people that constitute 99% of the world's population. Made in China is a boon for the masses. After the global financial crisis, the number of $1 shops in the United States has increased greatly, and some even appeared in high-end communities. The American middle classes began to join the group of the regular visitors to these stores. Among those in the $1 shops, Chinese products took up a large percent.
And all of a sudden, you realize that, you know, shoot, everything that was quality and good came from China. People got to China because they get it cheaper and quality. Anything better than miles at home.
Yeah.
That, and it costs a lot cheaper. I came back and I brought a suitcase. I bought so much stuff. I said, good. But that person, the quality is better. I said, people do great quality work and stuff like that. And that's, I think, that's the most important thing.
Made in China, with its fine quality and low price, satisfied the international market needs for diversity and has played a positive role in curbing global inflation and improving the purchasing power of consumers in various countries. Made in China is not only a boon for the masses, but also a blessing for businesses. For the last decade, alien companies have reaped huge benefits from made in China. With the rising trend of global economic integration, made in China, to some extent, has evolved to made with China, or even made for China. making multinational corporations share the Chinese bonuses. With over 1.3 billion people and the rising income growth, China has become the most lucrative potential market for almost every ambitious foreign business. The huge capacity of the Chinese market and low labor cost attracted more and more multinational corporations to made with China or even made for China. As of today, over 480 companies of the Fortune Global 500 have their investment in China. Foreign investment grew more than 9% annually during the past 10 years. With China's cooperation and participation, multinational corporations have found a new sustained growth engine and witnessed increased share of wealth. For the past decade, Made in China has contributed much to the world. Yet, what frequently appeared in the mainstream Western media were mainly the exaggerated quality issues of Chinese-made products. The bitter side of the Chinese blessing has remained unmentioned. On a gloomy day in August 2007, Foshan, Guangdong Province, China, a middle-aged Chinese man was found dead after hanging himself on the third floor of a warehouse. Next to his body were a pile of cute Sesame Street dolls. The man was Zhang Shuhong, a Hong Kong resident and co-owner of Foshan-based Li Da Industrial Company. 9 days before Zhang committed suicide, Mattel Incorporated, one of the largest U.S. toy companies, and the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission announced a recall of 967,000 plastic toys made by Li Da because they were allegedly decorated with paint found to have excessive amounts of lead. The company was forced to shut down, leaving 2,500 workers out of work. Under such heavy pressure, Zhang had no choice but to hang himself. After Zhang's suicide, investigations were immediately carried out by China's Ministry of Commerce. Ironically, the investigation revealed that the vast majority of the toys recalled were the result of a sudden change in the U.S. safety standard, not through a manufacturing flaw. Under heavy public opinion pressure, Mattel Incorporated apologized to China for the recall over a month later. After the bitter story comes the bitter memory. Li Shengjiao was a senior Chinese diplomat who spent most of his 40-year career overseas and commuted between China and Western countries. He knew Made in China stuff just as he knew his stuff. In those days, the products China exported to the Western countries were mostly the nation's best available. But those remained for domestic use were comparatively inferior ones. Chinese people saved the best for the West. Thank you. the bitter blessing is not over yet. A Made in China official mascot for the 2012 Olympics was priced at 20 pounds in London. However, on the other side of the world in China, the Chinese workers, hunched in rows over sewing machines, can only get as little as 18 pennies from one cuddly toy. The world-famous Barbie dolls, sold in more than 100 countries, were mainly manufactured in China. For each Barbie sold in America for $9.9, there is only 35 cents left to her Chinese mother for labor, plant, and electricity. Looking ahead, will the bitter number change for the better? Will Made in China make it?